Well, hello there. This is Cliff Cerces. We're coming to you with a very, very special Thanksgiving broadcast here on Music in the Word with the Cerces. And we're going to start off with a great song of Thanksgiving. Thank Him for the Miracle. Here's another song that's also written by Mosey Lister, the one that wrote the song that we just finished singing. I've heard this song for many, many years. What a beautiful song. The Man on the Middle Cross.
Crosses once stood, a was one without blame on the little cross, and a thief on either side. Oh, the man on the middle cross was my Lord, dying to save me from
Here's a very special song of thanksgiving called Thank You, Lord, for Your Blessings.
There are times when the Lord means so much to me that I want to kneel down and pray. Thank you for saving me.
Here's my favorite Mosey Lister song, Then I Met the Master.
No.
you enjoyed our music today. And we wanted to bring you songs that fit very well into this Thanksgiving theme. We have so much to be thankful for this year. And you say, what are you talking about, so much to be thankful for? This has been a horrible year. Well, it's not been the best for us. There have been a lot of things that have been unfortunate. We've had a lot of loss in a lot of areas. We've said goodbye to many friends, other people. I won't even begin to mention the folks that have gone home to be with the Lord that we were so close to this year. And so it's been a difficult year. But I want to tell you something. We're thankful. This is for us a year of thankfulness. And you say, how can that be? Well, for one thing, the scriptures command us and tell us that we ought to be thankful. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 and 7. It says, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Now, who couldn't say that this year we need the peace of God to transcend our understanding and to bring us peace? First Chronicles chapter 16, it tells us in verse 34, we are to give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, and his love endures forever. Well, Psalm 95, the first three verses of that psalm tell us, come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us sing aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song. For the Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods. And Psalm 69, it tells us in verse 30, I will praise God's name in song and glorify him with thanksgiving. And I could go on and on and on and spend the rest of this broadcast just reading you scripture after scripture where it tells us that we should come before the Lord with thanksgiving. I think you understand that. And you still say it's hard this year. What have I got to be thankful for? Well, I just took a few moments and jotted down a few things that I can honestly tell you that I'm thankful for this year. First of all, I'm thankful for my country. We are living in the most incredible country. I've not only been to, I guess, three other countries in my life besides the United States, but I've talked with so many that have traveled the world over, and they all say the same thing. They're so happy when they get off the plane and their feet once again touch our shore, because this is the greatest country on the face of the earth. Of course, it's got its flaws. Of course, there's things we wish were different. Of course, there are things about our country that may not be exactly like you would like them to be. And of course, there's room for improvement. But on the face of the earth, I don't believe there's any other country that comes close to what God's given us here in America. What a freedom we have. The freedom to have our own opinion. We have the freedom as Americans to voice those opinions. We've had the freedom as Americans to be able to not be afraid that they're going to take us and put us in jail for as a political prisoner because of the things that we said or the things that we wrote. You say, well, I'd like to have more freedom in that regard. Well, understand that the freedom that we have of speech that we are guaranteed by the Bill of Rights and the Constitution of our United States, realize in other countries, you speak your mind, and you give your opinion, you could wind up in jail. But not here. Not here. Well, it got me in trouble at work. Well, it got me in trouble with some friends. What I said got me in trouble here or there. Yeah, the Constitution doesn't tell you that you're not going to get disfavor from people for what you say. But it says the government's not going to take you and put you in jail for what you said and for what you think. And I believe we still have that right in America. Some try to challenge that at times, but the Constitution makes it clear. We are not about to be afraid of our government for what we say. I thank God for that. The Bible tells us to give honor to whom honor is due, and it tells us to give respect to whom respect is due. Read Romans chapter 13, and you won't miss the message that it tells us we are to pray for all of our leaders. Huh? Pray for who? All of our leaders. You know what the word all means? It means all. And so we're told to pray for our leaders. In fact, it's really kind of interesting. He says one reason you ought to pray for your leaders is really for your benefit, so that you will live in peace and so that you'll have a good life. You see, God's agenda is going to happen no matter who's in the White House. The things that God has purposed, he's going to do. Let me clue you. No man is going to cause that to happen, and no man is going to stop that from happening. What God has said, I will do, his agenda will go forward, and nobody will stop it. So let me tell you something. Romans 13 tells us that we should pray for good leaders because it's for our benefit, so we will live in peace, and so we will have a good life. But I want to tell you, if you're all discouraged because the person you voted for did not become president, let me tell you something. God's will of what he's going to do in our world today, it will go forward. God's agenda will not be stopped. But don't think that God's plan has now all of a sudden been put in the trash pile, and that God has to go back and scratch his head and come up with a new plan if the election did not go the way you wanted it to go. I'm going to pray for them. The Bible tells me to do that. It tells me to honor them, respect them, and to pray for them. And whether I'm happy with them or I'm not happy with them, I'm going to pray that God will bless them. I'm not going to pray, God, judge them. God, let everything come down upon their heads. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to pray curses on anybody. I'm going to pray blessings on people, okay? You know what it says in the Constitution and the Bill of Rights? It says, Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion. In other words, they can't establish a state religion and say, you must belong to this particular religion. But they also may not prohibit the free exercise thereof. Thereof of what? Of religion. They cannot prohibit the free exercise of religion or abridge the freedom of speech or of the press or the right of the people peaceably to assemble to petition the government for a redress of grievances. In other words, Congress is not allowed to pass any law at all that causes the exercise of religion to be shut down in any way or to be hindered in any way. And thank God for, in the midst of this terrible, terrible disease that's come upon us, thank God that there's been some positive things in the way that it's been addressed. I thank God for my family. I'll tell you what, my wife is just amazing. I'm married way up. No two ways about that. And I know that because very often people tell me, Cliff, you know, you married way, way up. That's very true. And I'm so proud of her. I just beam from ear to ear whenever I see her out there dealing with folks and whatever. She's a tremendous children's worker. She's a great singer. She's a great worker in the church. I'm just so proud of her, so many of the things that she does. And she's a very, very proud grandmother. And so I love family. I'm so glad for family. I'm so glad that God has given us such a wonderful family to be able to just enjoy their presence and be able to be with them and just to be so nurtured by them. I'm very, very thankful for our church. I'm prejudiced, but I think we go to the best church anywhere. I just am so blessed by our church. What a blessing it is. It's a blessing to the kids, the young, to the older folks, the middle-aged folks, and some of the younger adults that we have attending. And God has just caused us to have a closely knit body of people that just love us. They love us regardless of the warts that we have. They love me in spite of myself, okay? And it's just so wonderful to have that beautiful community of Christian folks, okay? I'm so glad for God's healing power and for his protection. You know, as I said earlier, we've not been invaded by any other country. We've not been attacked as we have been on 9/11 and other things that have happened in other times in our country. We've been really protected by God, I believe. And so we've not found ourselves in new wars. And we've had God protection. And as awful as this coronavirus has been, thank God there's been some protection. And he's healed us. We have folks that are friends of ours that have had the virus and they've come through it and they've been healed. Thing I think I'm most thankful for is that Christ went to the cross to die for our sins. It was something I did not deserve, but he went there and gave his own life that I might be able to live. Hey, I talked with a dear friend on the phone, a man named Ron Hensley. I heard him years ago on a record when he was with a group out in the West Coast sing this beautiful song on a live recording that was recorded on a record album, The Man on the Middle Cross, and then when he was with the Viscounts, I heard him sing it many, many times. And what a pleasure it was for years to actually be in a group called the Gabriels. And Ron was in the group along with some other buddies of mine, Frank Sanchez, George Jumper, and others. And what a great time we had those years. That song written by Mosey Lister first came to my attention when Ron sang it so beautifully. And that's one reason why I chose it today, sing it in his honor as we sang it earlier on the broadcast today. Because the man on the middle cross was my Lord. God caused my life to be turned around because he was willing to forgive me of my sins because of what was accomplished on that cross. You see, all of us should have to give our lives for the things that we have done. We really are standing before God. If we're standing in our own strength and we're standing in our own ability, we're standing before God very, very guilty of the things that we've done. But God says, I'm willing to wipe the slate clean because I allowed Jesus to take the penalty that you should receive for the things that you have done. And as a result, I'm going to forgive you. I'm going to wipe your slate clean. I'm going to see to it that there is absolutely nothing between me and you because I'm forgiving you for everything that you've done because of what Christ did on the cross and because of his resurrection. I think that's the thing I'm most thankful for today, the promise of a home in heaven and knowing that there's nothing between God and me, that I know that I can be accepted by him because my sins have been forgiven. This Thanksgiving season, can you say that? Is that true about you? Do you have the ability to say that God has so forgiven you that there's absolutely nothing between you and God? You can. Jesus made it very, very clear. Whoever comes to me, I will in no wise cast out. The scriptures tell us whosoever will may come. It tells us in scripture that if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And that is available for you right now. Can we pray together? Lord, I pray with this one that's listening to this broadcast today. And I believe that in their heart right now, they're praying, Lord, forgive me of my sins. I want to be able to go through this Thanksgiving thanking you for the ultimate thing to thank you for, forgiveness of my sins and a life with a relationship with you and the promise of a home in heaven. Lord, you can so easily give them that gift right now as they say, forgive me and let me live for you. Become my best friend. Let me enter into a relationship with you. And I pray that you'll hear that prayer. Let them feel the assurance right now that you have forgiven them and you're coming into their life and they're feeling something like they've never felt before. We thank you for it, Lord. They're going to spend time trying to read your Bible at least a little bit every day. Spend time just talking to you like they talk to anyone else. And Lord, you're going to just cause that relationship to just grow and grow and grow in the days ahead. And we thank you for it. We ask it in your precious name. Amen. Well, I hope you prayed that prayer. I hope you meant it. I hope you follow up on that. Tell someone you made that decision. And listen, Anita and I want to wish every one of you a beautiful and wonderful, happy Thanksgiving. God bless you. Please come back where you found us this time. You'll find us there next time, next week, on Music and the Word with the Cerces.